Niseme cabinet secretary because he is a member of our church, prime minister, honorable Raila, mheshimiwa Tim Wanyonyi, mheshimiwa Paranya na viongozi wengine, our senator Sifuna. Mine will be very brief. I want to talk about what is going on in the nation today. And sometimes we feel our MPs are not pushing what we want to be pushed. Currently, our leaders, I want to confess, things are not okay in this land. The economy is not very much okay. We look at what is going on, you are surprised. And when you go to Parliament, I was happy what Sifuna said last week, on this week during the President's speech, we are not speaking the truth on what is happening. As a church, we are praying, but we look around and we get surprised if this is the Kenya that we want. Schools will be open, our people need to go to school, parents are straining in the area of school fees, people cannot afford food, we don't have anything we can talk about. And Honorable Raila Odinga with your team, naomba uweke pressure kidogo, usaidie wananchi. Sisi wote hatuwezi kuongea, lakini wewe ukiongea, mambo ufanyika. So I'm really requesting you. Umenyamaza miezi sita tumekuwa worried. I want you to stand, start talking, arise, we are praying for you. Things are not okay. The bipartisan talks that are going on, we know they're supposed to bring a report maybe today. We don't know what is in that report. But you look at what is going on. For more than 6 months, we don't have IBC. Suppose anything happens in Kenya today, what will happen? I'm requesting if you can push the president, we get IBC in place before the end of this year. Ili mambo yanze kufanya kazi. Tukiingia mbele tuwe tunajua what we are going. Another thing that we are praying is that we look at what is being talked about education. Mambo ya school fees ya university, our children hawajalipiwa fees through the system ambayo imekuja, and we are requesting if this thing can be revived so that we find a way of helping our students to do exams. Lastly, we have talked about our brother, Honorable Tim Wanyonyi. Unajua, ila wakati 2022 we were shaken when he was told not to vie for governorship. Tulilia sana. Na ukimpigia simu na kuambia, Pastor, wache takuwa tu sawa, but we knew it was not okay. Tumekukubali akuwe governor 2027. But before we get there, Honorable Raila, I'm requesting, ule chairman wa ODM Nairobi ameenda kuwa governor Vihiga. Na kuomba kwa moyo mmoja. Mimi kama mchungaji, tukiwa hapa siku ya leo, ufanye Tim Wanyonyi akuwe chairman wa ODM Nairobi. Leo tu, ukituambia leo akuwe acting, because aladu anakimbia huko Vihiga kuwa governor wa Vihiga, patia huyu Tim Wanyonyi akuwe chairman wa ODM Nairobi leo tu saa hii. Ah. Tutaomba pa kesho asubuhi, tutafurahi. Tatoka hapa tukimbe tukisema kwamba tuko na chairman wa ODM Nairobi, Honorable Tim Wanyonyi. Na sisi, ukituona hivi mheshimiwa Raila, sisi ni hatari sana. Hii ni makanisa karibu 100 iko hapa. Na tukiamua tuanze kampeni ya kufanya mtu akuwe governor, 2 days, Tim yako governor wa Nairobi. And we are very ready. We are ready to go in every church, to call our members, our leaders, everybody in our churches, to make sure we achieve what we achieve. Because in 2022 we were very ready. And the team had worked in all churches and we were very ready. Tuliambia watu chukue kura waeke karibu kwa sababu ya team, tukaeka kura karibu. Wakati walisema ametolewa, roho zikakufa zote. Tukaulia, tukalia, lakini tukajua kwamba tuko na siku nyingine inakuja. Na hiyo siku imefika ni sasa. Na siku ya leo ya sasa ni kumfanya kuwa chairman wa ODM Nairobi. Kitu ya pili, ushikilie Sifuna aendelee kuwa senator wetu. Kitu ya tatu, Mama Dagoretti endelee kuwa Mama Dagoretti, Pasari endelee kuwa women rep yetu, tushike pamoja, tushikane tuendelee, and we shall raise other leaders to show you that Western vote in Nairobi is so powerful. Asanteni sana na Mungu awabariki.